Good day everyone! Today we will be talking about Blender Cycles performance. I had to upgrade my Blender rig and I was curious, is it better to have more CPU cores or higher clock? I wasn't sure about Blender scaling to gain speedups of additional processing cores, so I did experiments to help me pick out a new CPU. Hope it will help you too in making decision. Enjoy! Our testing platform has Intel Core i5 dual core processor. It is based on the Sandy Bridge architecture and offers hyperthreading. The base clock speed is 2.6 GHz. As benchmark tool, we pick latest Blender build 2.68. The operating system is a 64-bit Windows 7 with the latest service pack. Testing stand will be a great MicPan automotive model. You can find it on Blender Artist forum, link in description. Before we start, I made sure that only CPU is enabled for cycles. We can check it in User Preferences System tab, inside the Compute Device section. To measure the time used to render the scene, just click Render button. The results are presented in the top part of screen. First, I did experiments with CPU multiplier to simulate different CPU models. We do like that to manipulate CPU speed only and nothing more. Raise the front side boost is basically changing everything that runs. As we see, the CPU frequency improved render efficiency so nice. I was really surprised about this linear speedup. Let's start with hyperthreading. The rendering time is actually faster with HD enabled by about 30%. Another big advantage is more responsible operating system. While Blender rendering as 10, we can still work on another application, checking email, etc. Blender has really good linear scaling. In general, the speedup is equal to core frequency. Doubled frequency solo core equal to half frequency dual core. The number of processing cores provide linear performance gain. These results imply that the speedup of Blender cycles remains steady across the core amount and frequency. It's worth to get more cores. Thank you for watching, see you next time.